give God all the glory. He is worthy of the honor. He is worthy of the praise. We give him thanks this morning. We give him thanks this morning. He didn't have to wake us up, but he did, and we give him thanks. He didn't have to let us see another day, but he did, and we give him thanks. Go on, open up your mouth and give God some praise. Give God some praise, because he's worthy. He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. We thank you this morning. God, we thank you this morning. Open up your mouth and give God all the praise. We give you the glory this morning, for you are excellent. You are mighty, and we worship you on this morning. God, we give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. It's you, day, but we still are thankful. We are thankful to see this day. We are thankful. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, we praise you this morning. And we lift your name on high. Hallelujah. At this time, we're going to have the prayer done by missionary Doreen. And follow that will be scripture by Sister Harmony.
Amen. I
know it's Youth Day, but we are still here to give God all the glory and all the honor. The youth is coming at this moment to give praise. We want you to get involved and give God all the glory. Amen.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
are holy. And because you are holy, God, we need your fire to fall on us. And because you are great, God, we need your fire to fall on us. We need the fresh fire, God. We need a fresh wind of fire, God, to fall on us. Because you are worthy, we need your fire to fall. Because you are worthy, God, we need your fire to fall. We need your fire to fall in this place, God. Because you are worthy, God, we need the fire to fall. We need fresh fire, God. We need the fresh fire to fall. I don't know what week you had this week, but on this week I had a trying week. I had a rough week. I dealt with some things. But because you are holy, God, you worked it out. And I thank you for it, God. That's why I tell you to give God all your praise. Because you don't know what you got to deal with on next week. That's why you need to give God your praise. Because your praise will hold you. Your praise will cover you. Your praise will help you through whatever. Give God the praise, and whatever you're dealing with, God will work it out. Hallelujah, God. If you give God your praise, whatever you're dealing with, God will work it out. He will go before you. He will go before you, and he will work it out. That's why I give God all my praise. You don't know what hell you're going to deal with. You don't know what you're going to face. You don't know what's going to come your way. But if I can just give my God all the praise, if I just lift my hands and worship, if I just give it to him, he'll work it out. He will work it out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. That's why you need to give God praise. Young people, you don't know what you're going to face this week. You don't know. You don't know what you need to give God praise. Give God praise for keeping you. Give God the praise for covering you. Give him your best praise. Give him your best praise. Give him your best praise. You need to give God all the glory. He deserves it. 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 That's why he's holy. That's why he is holy. That's why he is holy. He deserves my praise. Hallelujah, Jesus. We'll be right back.
Hallelujah. We give you the honor. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. We thank you, God. And we give you all the glory. We give you all the glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. You are worthy.
Usual. No more church as usual. We need to go to another level, God. So send your fire, God. Send your fire, God. We need to go to another level, God. So send your fire. Send your fire, God. Send your fire, God. Let it fall. Let it fall. Let it fall. Hallelujah, Jesus, God.
Thank you.
need to come up here and ask God for it so he can work it out for you. While he is here, you need to come. While he is here, you need to come. Right now. Right now. Don't let it be too late. Come right now. Whatever you need is here. Whatever you need, God. We need fresh fire. If you need it, come. Fresh fire, God. Just begin to praise him for it. Hallelujah.
Thank you. presence is here right now. There is a reason. Whenever he steps into the room and visits, there is a reason. We praise God for the praise and the worship. Praise God for the youth choir. It is Youth Sunday. And I believe there is a testimony. Deacon Cope is saying he wants to testify.
Amen, amen. Good morning, church. I just want to, as I was sitting there listening to Aspire Missionary Center talking about how God would bring you through whatever you're going through, whatever's going to happen. If you give God the praise, he'll bring it through. And my mind goes back to Tuesday morning. And for those of you who don't know, I work in lawn care. And what I do every morning, I get up at 4:30, 4:45, read my scripture, say a prayer before I leave the house. And then when I get to the job, to the shop, me and the guys, we say another prayer. We ask the Lord to protect us on the highway and to protect the equipment and the vehicles that we're riding in. So Tuesday we was in Altima coming out 4:36. And I was telling my wife about this. And she said, if something happened to you, you know I'm coming. So what was going on the trailer? Now this is the second time that this trailer has messed up on us. But this time it was totally different. We riding down 4:36 going to the next yard, and the driver looks through the window and said, he actually fell in the back. He said, James, look through the rearview mirror and look at that tire on the trailer. Look, is it funny? Is it wobbling? And we kept hearing the noise all morning long. But you know, we wasn't paying attention because we were talking and getting ready for the next yard. And we stopped on 436 on Westmont Drive. And we got out and we looked at the tire. And Brother Pastor, let me tell you. Now, you know you have to. When you take a tire off the rim, you have to loosen the nuts on the tire. We got to this tire, and all three of us got down and looked at that tire, and we started messing with the tire. And we just pulled the whole tire off. You know what I'm saying? Without taking the lugs off. And when we pulled that tire off, we could see where everything had burned up on the inside. The ball bearings and everything was burned up. Now, had we been on I-4, riding, and we don't really ride fast, but you know, sometimes you get a little foot heavy on the gas. Had we been on I-4 and that tire would have just came off that trailer, and we could have had an accident. We could have, but by the prayers of the righteous, you know what I'm saying, church? The prayers of the righteous. Now, I don't know if the other brothers in the truck is saved, but that's between them and their God. But I know the relationship that I have with God. I say, Lord, protect us on this highway. And that is no other protection than what he just did for us on Tuesday morning. We was able to pull that tire off. And the thing about it, I tell my wife, the boss man, he said, keep on working. I said, now, y'all know we can get a ticket. The sheriff stopped us, and the thing about what when I said that, we stopped at a Circle K to get something to drink, and there was two sheriff deputies sitting right there. They didn't say a word. So that showed me that God will protect you no matter what. So that's my testimony this morning. God did above and beyond on Tuesday morning. Like I said, this is the second time that trailer has done the exact same thing. The wheels all go out. But by the grace of God, by the prayers of the righteous. Yes, God. The prayers of the righteous availeth much. That's what scripture tells us. So I just thank God for protecting me, not only me, but protecting my co-workers as well. So we'll be able to go along another day. Thank you.
My God. Come on, let's give God some praise. Let's give him some praise. I was just listening to Deacon Cope tell his testimony, and I know God is he's always up to something. And listen to the sister, aspiring missionary Sally. She's ready. About a week ago. See, the enemy tries to mess with the head first to get to the body. And it was about a week ago the Lord spoke to me and said to pray for the saints because they're going to experience some mechanical issues. It was about a week ago. And then I heard some things. I got some phone calls from some of the members. And I began to pray, Lord, protect my members. Protect them even from death. Protect them. And as I was traveling to Jacksonville, Sister Lawrence called me about 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning while I was driving. She said, I said something's wrong. And then, you know, as husbands sometimes, like, everything's good, everything's fine. She says, no, but the Lord showed me something. And about that two days after, went to go and get the car looked at. Driving from Jacksonville, and I was driving 70, 80 miles an hour. I felt the shift. I just kept going. I went into the Firestone, and the gentleman called me back. They said, you need to look at your tire. I had placed all the tires on my car. Then he said, do you know your tire was split in half? Do you see this tire right here? This tire has a big hump on it. He said, now if you would not have come in there, you see, understand, we know what we're supposed to do in the natural realm. We know what we're supposed to do. But you know, sometimes we procrastinate because of other things. But we just thank God it's the Holy Ghost that keeps us even through our stupidness when we're supposed to do stuff. And as the youth choir was singing, let the fire fall. See, the fire covers up everything, every foolish thing that we do. The fire covers us. Hallelujah. If you could do me one more favor that Sister Sally had us to do, just stand to your feet and just thank God for the fire that covers you, even through your stupid stuff. The things that we do, we know we're supposed to take care of things, but sometimes on our human side, we procrastinate. We know we procrastinate with things that's supposed to be done, but just thank God for His grace and thank God for His mercy that covers us. Even through our crazy men. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your grace. Come on, new beginnings. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your mercy.
Go ahead and do the announcements at this time. The Lord's going to fill in. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. And these are our morning announcements. A call to prayer. Join us for prayer every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday morning at 6:45 a.m. for 15 minutes of powerful prayer, where you will be led by the missionary department on Mondays, our ministerial staff on Wednesday, and by our great jurisdiction, the Florida Eastern Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction, on Friday morning. You can join us for prayer by dialing into the prayer line at 1-605-562-8400, or you may dial 1-712-832-8330. Enter the access code 8109934#, and just like that, you are in. Join us every Tuesday night at 7:30 p.m. for Bible Study Live with our Pastor Superintendent Timothy Lawrence and our special guests. Sunday School, Sunday School. Join us every Saturday evening at 9 p.m. for Sunday School on Saturday night with our very own district Sunday School President, Dr. Veronica O'Brien. Bring your notepad, pen, and Bible, and get ready to be taught and blessed with a powerful lesson. If you want more of Sunday School, you can join us on Sunday morning at 10 a.m. with our very own Dr. O'Brien. Come join us in our service. You may view us online or you may join us live in our worship experience. It begins at 11 a.m. every Sunday morning. We are located at 853 State Road 436, Castleberry, Florida, 32707. Due to the social distance guidelines, if you plan to attend any service at New Beginnings, we ask that you will please wear a mask. There will be a temperature check station at the door. If you want to know more about the New Beginning Ministry, or you want to send a prayer request, please call us, email us, or you may send mail to the ministry, and someone from our team will contact you. You can call us at 321-314-5309. Our email address is NBMOOCOGIC@gmail.com. Again, that is NBMOOCOGIC@gmail.com. Our mailing address is P.O. Box 608-355, Orlando, Florida 32860. New Beginning also has an active website. You may come join us online at our website address, www.nbmoocogic.org. New Beginnings would like to wish everyone who is celebrating a birthday in the month of September or an anniversary, if that is you, we say happy birthday to you. We say happy anniversary to you, and we pray God's speed of blessing over your life. We have our women's conference coming up October 8th, 9th, and 10th. Feel free to join us. You may register online with the New Beginnings Ministry. The registration fee is $30. The New Beginnings Ministry Ladies Department is asked to pay their assessment on today. Today is your deadline. We also have events that we're scheduling for this event, and we're asking that you see us, the Women's Department, and our President, Minister Cope, at the service today for further information. These are all of our announcements. We will turn this service over into the hands of our pastor. Let's thank God for him, Superintendent Timothy Lawrence.
I don't have to wipe this mouth, right? We got the same germs. We got the same clues. Amen. We thank God. There was another announcement that was already put in the bulletin for our announcement clerk. We pray that all is well with her and her travels to the church. But today is I Love My Church Sunday. Amen. So this is what we're supposed to do. I want you to get your phones out. even for the members that are watching via social media, to the YouTube, to Facebook, to Instagram. Y'all say so much, I love my church. I'm so glad to be a part of the ministry. But miss, your wife is looking at, I'm glancing over, she looking at the camera, looking at her face, and combing her hair. I said, get your phones out.
That's all the time out.
Amen. So this is what I want you to do. Because you say so much, I love my church. I love what we're doing. So I want you to take a picture. Look at Mother Lingo. She's here. Look, she's looking pretty.
Amen.
Amen. I want to help Mother Lingo out, Sister Dana, on her page too. I want you to take a photo. And you're going to take a photo and you're going to tag your church. All the young people, I know y'all on Instagram. And we're going to evangelize, because this is I love my church. So I want you to take a photo and tag your church and say, I love my church, hashtag, which is the power, NBMOO. All right, I'm going to do that later when I get a chance. So when you do that, I want you to write something. Even young people, if it's on Instagram, write why you love your church. And write down, why do you think somebody should visit your church? Now, it's sad when you when you don't love your church and you don't want nobody to visit your church.
Right, right.
Are you too embarrassed? So, you know, some people embarrassed, but some people come to their church. You know what I'm saying? Amen. But if you love your church, I want you to post a picture. Say, I love my church. Hashtag, I think it's pound NBMOO, which will go in the symbol of our church, and tag your church in. If you don't know how to tag, ask somebody how to tag, or you can see Aspire Missionary Sally, who keeps up everything social for us. She'll tell you how to tag your church. But then write down, I want you to write down why you love your church, okay? So don't just say you love your church. I want to read in the comment section why you love your church. All right? And let's encourage the members that are not here on this morning to do the same today, to do it today, which is Sunday. Today is I Love My Church campaign. They're doing it. Most churches are doing it across the world today. I love my church. So today is that Sunday. Amen. While you're doing that, we're going to call our very own Dr. O, amen, to the platform to do what she needs to do in our education department. The mic wiper is really slow this morning. Y'all forgive her. She hasn't had her. Come on, mic wiper.
Bless the Lord. Good morning again. Good morning. I too just want to confirm the prophetic ministry, Pastor, because on Monday, when I switched on my car, all the lights came on. When they did a diagnosis on the car, it's the brake. And so I give God thanks to be standing here this morning.
Yeah.
I want to invite a young lady. This should have happened from last month. I wasn't able to be at the youth program. And so we have a certificate for someone who has served so willingly as required. We're looking forward to having a young people's teacher for Sunday school. And so for the month of August, I'd like for you to help me to celebrate Sister Tamaya Sally. This certificate was ready for you from last month. And so we ask that you continue serving. I admire the way you teach Sunday school. And so I just want to say God bless you as you continue to serve. Bless you.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise
Come
Lord.
On, praise the Lord, everybody. The Lord. Hallelujah. We've been having church up in here. If you're viewing us, it's hot in here. Amen. The fire of God has been in this place. and he has touched our hearts, and we're excited about it. Amen. We're getting ready for offering. Amen. We're getting ready to bless ourselves with our tithe and with our offering. Amen. Anybody excited about giving unto the Lord? I'm excited about giving unto the Lord because he's been so good to us. He's been so good to me. Amen. We're going to have our youth, a couple of our youth come. If you're on this screen and you're viewing on today, there's several ways you can give, and we appreciate it in advance. Amen. As you donate, amen. As you give to this house, amen. There's Giveify, there's Cash App. You can mail it in, amen. I believe you have, we have different ways you can give, amen. So we ask that you might just be a blessing, amen. As the Lord bless you, bless yourself. Hallelujah. We got tithe givers. We believe in giving our tenth. Amen. Back unto the Lord. Amen. Because we promise that he'll open up the windows of heaven and pour us out a blessing. Hallelujah. Our youth are doing an awesome job today, are they?
Amen.
Amen. They've been singing. Amen. I had the pleasure of being in practice with them. They did better than what I thought. Sister Michelle, Sally, and the anointing put that thing together. Yes, amen. Y'all continue to pray for us as we go higher in the Lord. Amen. We're going to pray. We're going to ask that one of our youth pray over this offering. Today I'm going to have my son, Brother John, pray over the offering, and then we're going to get ready to give, okay? They're going to bless us. We're going to have a brief word, and then we're going to get on home, okay? Y'all like that? We agree with that? Can we say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Come on, somebody, put your hands together.
fight every day. When I watch it, what I pray. I know what is that, I won't go back.
I'm
Lightly, we don't put it aside, but God, we thank you for your presence being here, God. Now continue to have your way, send your anointing even more, and we'll give you all the glory, and we'll give you all your praise. It is in your Son Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen,
amen.
And amen, and amen. Hallelujah. We do give God glory for being here today. Amen. We thank God. Give a hand clap to our youth on today. Come on, come on. Hallelujah. They did such a wonderful job. I thank God for prayer. Amen. Because what you can't see with your own natural eyes, you put it in the hands of the Father in prayer. He'll work something out. Amen. He'll start turning things around. Amen. He'll start putting his favor on it. Amen. I'm so glad that God is an awesome God. He's a magnanimous God. He's an untouchable God.
Yes.
He's undeniable, unstoppable God. He's unbelievable. He's unmatched. Amen. He's so great. I can talk about God all day because he's that good to me. Amen. He's been a father when I've been fatherless. He's been a mother when I've been motherless. He's been a friend when I've been... Come on, do anybody know about the God that we serve? That he's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be lifted up. Amen. He said, if you lift him up, he'll draw all men unto him. Amen. He's so awesome. He's a protector, deacon. Can he protect you? Amen. Even when you're in your car. Even when you're not paying attention. He's a shield. The buckler, mother. I start thinking about the goodness of Jesus. I ain't talking about me. I ain't talking about pastor. I'm not talking about my kids. But when we start talking about the Savior, when I start thinking about how good he's been to me, how he's brought me from a mighty long way, how he's still carrying me, how he's still covering me. When I start talking about Jesus, about our Savior, he's worthy of the glory and he's worthy of every praise. Amen. We thank God for our minister, our visiting minister. Amen. Amen. We thank God he's a familiar face and his two boys. Hallelujah. What a delight it is to see them faces in the house of prayer and the house of the Lord on today. Amen. We thank God for it. We just want to give God all the glory and all the praise. Because he's so worthy of all the praise and all the glory. We thank God for pastor allowing us. Come on, yes, yes. We thank God for him allowing us just to have this service, amen, just to express our gifts and our talents unto the Lord on today. And I promise I won't be before you long, amen. We give God glory for Sister Sally, expiring missionary evangelist. Amen. She has outdone herself today. Amen. She just found out that she was going to MC
this morning when she came to through the doors of the sanctuary. Amen. I said, "You MCing? There's the MC right there. MC Hammer. There she go right there. She right there. She right there." But I'm surely I'm glad that the Lord or she allowed, because she has to allow God to have His way. She allowed the Lord to use her, because all He needs is a willing vessel. Amen. Amen. Because when we allow God to use us and to do what He wants with us, the people are blessed. Amen. The people are blessed. Amen. Just like you allowed your voice to express that testimony. Amen. But if you would have shut that thing up, nobody would have understood. There would have been not an amen in here. But when you allow God to use your vessel, amen, hey, He will be glorified. I feel the fire in here today. Anybody, I feel the fire in here today. I believe that I'm in agreement that God just wanted some praise on today. He wanted some praise. He wanted some worship. He wanted some adoration. He wanted to be lifted up in this place. I'm telling you, and it's not done yet. I believe God. I believe that he just wanted worship. I was trying to say, Lord, what do you want for your people? What try to go back into, you know how we do preachers. We try to go back into our catalog and see something we preached before. See, we can master that a little bit more. Amen. But God wouldn't allow me to do it. He wouldn't allow me to give something that wasn't ordained or wasn't for the people of God today. But I thank God early this morning. I'm talking about real early, mother, like around 2 a.m. Sometimes you just got to sit until God moves. Sometimes you just got to sit in His presence until He talks to you. And sometimes you just got to get on your knees, talk to God a little bit more, go on about your business. 30 minutes, talk to Him a little bit more until He moves.
That's right.
You don't move until He moves.
That's right.
We want to quit things. We want to talk to God for 5 minutes and keep it moving. We don't want to sit in His presence. But I had to sit there. God, I had to sit there. And if you will, amen, I promise this ain't going to be a long message. This is going to be real quick because we've already there. We already in His presence, amen. I want to talk a little bit about praise on today. According to what's going on already. Already we've been praising all day. So I affirmed it in His word. Sometimes all we got to do is just give God praise.
That's right.
It's just give, in spite of how we feel, in spite of what we're going through, just give God a praise. And I believe He will be well pleased with that. Psalms 106. Psalms 107. I got y'all, huh? I want to make sure y'all paying attention. Amen. Now, y'all going to help me preach this today, amen. And we're going to sing this. If you have your Bibles, get next to somebody that has a Bible. Amen. Because we're going to read the scripture out loud together. We're going to declare this thing according to what the word says. Psalms 107. We're going to go 1-3. Come on. Find somebody that has a Bible. Come on, y'all people. Find somebody that has a Bible. If you have a Bible, that means we're standing. That means we're standing. If you don't have a Bible, find someone that has a Bible that we can read this. Amen. That we can read this. And we're talking about praise on today. We're talking about praise on today. Are we ready? So we're going to read 1-3, and then we're going to jump to verse 8. Okay? Y'all ready? We're going to do it all together. 1-3.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good. His mercy endures forever.
Let the redeemed
of the Lord say so, whom He has redeemed from the hand of the enemy.
Come on.
And gather them out of the lands of the east and from the west, from the north and from the south.
Oh,
that man would praise the Lord. His goodness and for the words to the children.
Okay. All right. You may be seated. Amen. Amen. And I'm going to read it. It says, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good,
For his mercy endures forever. I like this right here. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Do I have any redeemed folks? Amen. Woo, I like that. I like that. Why did David say, let the redeemed of the Lord say? Why did he say, let the saved folks say so? Why did he say, let the righteous folks say so? Why did he say, let the Holy Ghost say so? Why did he say, let the living say so? He said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. So when you've been redeemed, that means one time you were lost, you were outcast, you were gone, you were discarded. But when you have been redeemed, he said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy. I don't know about you, but I haven't been saved all my life. Amen. I haven't been saved. The devil had me going back and forth, to and fro, at one point in time. See, that's why you can tell what the thankful and the grateful people are. The ones that want to make some noise and don't mind giving God praise, because they know they've been in the hands of the enemy. They know if it had not been for the Lord on their side, they wouldn't be sitting here or standing here today. That's why you can tell who has been thankful and who has been, I'm okay. Real quick, I'm okay. I love him. I appreciate him. There's a different thing of being, I want y'all to catch this real quick. If y'all don't catch anything else, catch this right here. It's a difference in being the act of thankful or being thankful and then the act of praise. There's a difference from being thankful. God, I thank you. You know, I thank you. But it's a different thing from when you praise God. When you praise God. See, people get that confused. Oh, I praise God. I say my prayers and all this stuff, and I get on my knees. But there's a difference of when you are thankful unto God and when you're praising God. And it says like this. It says, oh, that man would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of man. Oh, that man would praise the Lord. Why? For his goodness. Why should you praise the Lord? Because he's been good to you. Why should you give him glory? Because he's made a way for you. Why should you praise him? Because he's so awesome in all his works. It says that the children of man, it's almost like you got to plead with people to praise God.
That's right.
My God.
You got to make an announcement to praise God. You gotta hype people up to praise God. You gotta amp them up. You gotta talk to them. You gotta sing in the right key for them to pray. You gotta have music and you gotta have the drums to praise God. But the Bible says, oh, that man would praise him, not because of the music, not because of the drums, but because of his what? His goodness. His goodness, his goodness, his goodness. Oh, I forgot to tell y'all my title, I'm sorry. My bad. We can put his goodness, we can put that as a down drop. But see, I gotta make this thing personal right here. The title of this message is that I'll praise him. I don't need your help, but I'll praise him. Let's go to Luke real quick. Luke, and you'll see in the verse in Luke, the 19th chapter, the 37th verse, Luke 19 and 37. Uh-huh. And it blew my mind. Luke 19 and 37. Because I'm a praising. I don't know about you, but I'm a praising. I'm a praising. For his goodness. Preachers say for his goodness. Uh-huh. Luke 19 and 37 through the 40th verse. The verse I want to bring to your attention is the 40th verse. But Luke 19 and 37, it reads, and when he was come nigh, even now at the descent of the mountain, we're talking about Jesus of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen.
saying, blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. Verse 39, and some of the Pharisees from among the multitude said unto him, Master, rebuke thy disciples. And he answered, this is Jesus answering the Pharisees. He said, he answered and said unto them, I tell you that if these should hold their peace, the stones would immediately cry out. I'll praise them. I don't need a rock crying out for me. So these are declarations that we have to say to ourselves, that I have to take responsibility for my own praise. I have to take responsibility for my own worship. Because I understand this is the Lord that blessed me and nobody else. See, we're living in a tricky time and a tricky season in this and tricky season and age, mother. They don't make them like they used to, mother. We real finicky. We're real sensitive. You can't say the wrong thing to somebody and they don't talk to you for the rest of the year. And if you don't say hi, if you don't look at them in the right frame or the right direction, oh, they got a problem with me today. We're real finicky. We're real wishy-washy these days. Oh, they didn't call me last week, so I guess they don't care about me. They still owe me money from 5 years ago, and I ain't let that go. It's $20, and I still can't forgive them. We real funny. We trade allegiances. We trade tribes, and we trade teams like we changing our underwear. And I hope you change them every day. I mean, we can't keep friends long, because they just don't make them like they used to. They just don't make them like they used to. So just imagine somebody trying to give you applause because you got your GED or because you got your associate's degree. You work hard for that hairdo. You work hard and they can't congratulate you no more. Because you ain't talk to them, because you ain't seen them in the light, because you know, real finicky. And you gotta be careful who you hang around with. You gotta be careful who you hang around, because there's always somebody in your ear talking about you ought not praise the Lord like that. There's always somebody. God ain't worthy of all that praise. It was that bank teller. It was that loan department. It was the government that did that. God ain't do that. It was the friends that you was around and gave you that job. You gotta be careful who you hang around with. The Bible says that the Pharisees was hating on Jesus. Oh God, I thank you right here. They were hating on Jesus as he was entering in the city. Because the people was giving them praise, The people was giving them worship, talking about it's not respectful to give this man this type of praise. But one thing I like about God, God knowing their heart, they said, if these people don't give me praise, the rocks will cry out. But you might ask, why should I praise the Lord? I'm going to help you right here. Because in this text in Luke, Doc, it's amazing. I just this morning in this text in Luke. Now this is Jesus when right before he about to be crucified. When he was coming in as a donkey, can you still praise God when he comes in and he doesn't look like the King of Kings and the Lord of the Lord? When he's coming in and riding on a donkey, when he doesn't make a way when you think he should have made him, can you still give God glory if you still get sick? And can you still give God glory if your car still get ripped? So he was coming in riding on a donkey, not on a lion, not on a horse, but he was riding on a donkey. But it was giving him worship. But you got to imagine Jesus right here. He knows he's about to be crucified. Oh my God, I thank you. He knows he's about to be crucified. And he knows the very same people that's giving him praise and worship one day is going to be saying, crucify him the next.
But this is how powerful your praise is. Jesus knew that they were going to say crucify him. And so Jesus could have said, well, Pharisees, you're right. They need to shut all that praise down because they're going to say hallelujah and congratulate me and be my friend one day. And then 2 days from now, they're going to act like they ain't even know who I was. Like I ain't made that miracle. Like I ain't get fed them or nothing like that. He could have did that, but he said no. If they don't praise me now, woo! That's why sometimes you need to get an advanced praise. Every opportunity you need to give God praise because you don't know when it's going to be your last time. Matter of fact, you need to give God so much praise that you need to have some credit in the heavenly bank account. You need to make some deposits right now where everything is good so God can reflect back. No, I know he's going to talk back about me. I know he's going to go offshore a little bit. I know he's going to get off course a little bit. But I remember when he praised me. I know it don't look good right now, but the beginning is just the beginning. There's an ending and it's going to end in glory.
Yes. All right.
I like how Jesus looks at things. He said, don't let them stop praising me. I know they're going to cuss me tomorrow. Don't let them stop praising me. I know they're going to go cheat on me tomorrow. I know they're going to steal from me tomorrow, but don't let them stop praising me because this is the time that the redeemed of the Lord, why did he do that? Because he knew he was going to redeem them.
All right. That's right.
He knew he was going to redeem them. He knew that we were going to get off course one day. He knew that we were going to make some mistakes one day. Let me tell you this, and I'm almost closing right here, because I'm responsible for my praise. I'll praise, but I don't know about you. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm a praiser.
I'm a praiser.
I'm a praiser. I'm a praiser. I'm a praiser. I'm a praiser. I'm not going to let the devil shut me up. I'm not going to let my friends tear me down because God's been so good to me. I'm going to praise him. I'm so thankful to the Lord, and I'm so thankful to the Lord. We had all this praise and worship in here. Amen. We seen God perform, and we seen God do things that we naturally wouldn't do. Because a lot of times, I'm kind of shy, to be honest with you. I was very shy when I was my son. I'm naturally a shy person. And get this. I really am. I'm really naturally shy. I used to be real shy, Pastor. Cause guess what?
Yeah, I know that right, everybody.
When I was young, I was insecure of who I was. When I was young, I didn't know where I belonged, how to fit in. When I was young, I I'm naturally shy. Because I don't know how you're going to accept me. That's how I was when I was young. But I'm so thankful. Because when I was young, I felt like an outcast. I felt like a bastard. Felt like a stepchild. And bastard just meaning that I was a part. I wasn't my daddy's son. I really didn't. Me and my dad, we didn't talk a lot. We didn't play a lot. You know what I'm saying? Great man. I love him to death. We have the best relationship now. Very responsible. That's why I get my responsibility. That's why I work. But me and him didn't click. I was his only boy, and I thought me and him were going to be tight. So, you know, I was very shy. But I always knew God was working in my life because my parents put me under the influence of church. They dragged me to church. And sometimes they didn't have to drag me to church, but I was excited to go to church because that's what it was. I used to love being in the youth choir and the youth doing all this type of stuff. But I had my own mind. I was confused. I wanted to be in the world. I wanted to be with the Lord. The Lord would minister to me at nighttime when everybody was asleep. I remember my soul loved Jesus. My soul loved Jesus. My soul loved Jesus. Bless his name. I used to say that at nighttime. Nobody listen. 7 years old, my soul loves Jesus. My soul loves Jesus. My soul loves Jesus. Bless his name. But at the same time, I was 10 years old And I got separated from my family because I was so bad. They said I had a learning disability. I was bad. I got kicked out of the whole country. I ain't playing, I'm dead serious. My dad was in the military, we in Germany. I'm acting a fool, about to mess up my dad's career on the base, 10 years old. They say, look, you either gonna have to retire or get out the military because your son, I'm in there breaking glass, breaking into buildings and just doing all miscellaneous stuff, shooting BB guns at people as they drive. I was bad for no reason. My soul loved Jesus. My soul loved Jesus. But I was confused. I didn't know what God was dealing with me. So, yeah, so we had to, so we had to leave, or they had to, my parents had to ship me to Florida to stay with my aunties and them. While they stayed, he finished in Germany. So for 2 years, I was separated from my family, and I was in a bad place for kids. 10 years old! 10 years. So I was always shy, but God was still ministering to me. At 12 years old, they came back to the United States of America. I was with my auntie and them, and I was in this, I wasn't with them, but they were watching over me as I was in this facility for bad kids. I had ADD, you understand what I'm saying? They had me on medicine, and all this stuff, special ed. I was a special ed until I was like in the 7th or 8th grade. But you can't tell it, can you? I know you can't tell it. You know, I'm not the smartest person in here. I know. But when you look over my story, you don't even know the half of it. I don't know the half of your story. So when the Bible says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he has redeemed from the hands of the enemy, it doesn't make no sense for me to pump and prime you to praise God.
That's right.
I'm going to be responsible for my praise. I'm going to take responsibility for me giving God glory for all his many goodness and all his many works. I'm not going to let the enemy talk to me on one shoulder talking about, now you're in front of your friends, you don't need it. Yeah, it's not the right time to say thank you, Jesus. It's always an appropriate time to say thank you, Jesus. I don't care if you're in the locker room, in the bathroom, in the classroom. It's always an appropriate time to say thank you, Jesus. Because
oh, yeah.
The Bible declares that if you don't praise God, we just read it in the Word. If we don't open up our mouth and give God praise, something else going to praise him. And I don't want that something else to be praising for me. When I have a mouth, I can give them glory. When I have my hands, I can put them together. When I can stump my feet, I want to give God praise. Why? Because of his goodness. God's been good to me. And I know he's been good to you. If God has brought you from a mighty long way.
Yes, sir. Oh, yes.
Say so, sir. And he's still doing mighty things for you. You ought to give God praise. And give him glory, for he's worthy of everything that we have.
Yes, he is.
Be responsible for your praise. Don't let the devil take away the praise. Again, right before you say, if you don't praise me, the rocks will cry out. You got to understand this. Life journeys is going to take us through some trifling things. It's going to take us through some ups and some downs, some in and some outs. And this year for me, I don't know about nobody else, this year for me has been one of the most trying years in a long time. Trying years. It may look good. I had some good moments, Pastor. I ain't going to lie. Had some doors open for me. I had some favor been upon my life. But the devil knows how to try you.
That's right. Yes, he does.
He knows exactly what buttons to push.
Amen.
He knows exactly. And people think you're doing good and everything is well, but the devil knows how to try you. So this has been some trying year for me. But when I think of his goodness,
oh,
When I reflect back then of all he has brought me through, I know I'm not perfect, but I will never turn back. Pastor, I'll never turn back because he brought me from a mighty long way.
Mighty long way.
Mother Lord. Mother Lord. Should have been dead sleeping in my grave. Should have been locked up in somebody's prison. Should have been a bed of affliction, but God has been good. And so I'll praise him. I'll give him glory. I'll give him worship. I want to encourage every young person in here, give God glory. Don't be ashamed of where you come from. Don't be mother. You're going to sing it just this morning. You're going to sing. I see you over there. You can sing. You're going to give us a good old church song. Don't worry about it. We got you. Get it together. Yeah, she was over there clapping and singing. I'm going to turn the mic over to you just a second. Yeah. But we're going to work it today. Young people, Mother Linga been here for a long time, and she's still serving the Lord.
Amen.
That's her daughter, Dina, sit right there. And she's still serving the Lord. Not saying that they had some ups and they had some downs. They had some ins and outs. They had some good days and bad days. But God's worthy to be praised. Don't be ashamed. Give God his praise. Why? Because he's been good to you. He's been good to your parents. He's been good to your pastors. And he's been good to us. Amen. Are y'all going to give God praise? Amen. We've been praising God. He's worthy of the glory. And he's worthy of praise. I'll give him praise.
Amen, amen.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and he's worthy to be praised. Let everything that have breath praise the name of the Lord. For he's worthy of all the glory. Did he do it for you? Did he do it for you? I know we got some testimony that God did it for me. That God opened up some doors. Sister Monica, he's still doing it. He's been a healer. He's been a deliverer. He's been our strong tower. Amen. We're going to hear a song from Mother Lingo. Amen. And whatever youth, this Mother Lingo, this our season, whatever song she comes, she's going to sing that song. We're going to have some prayer from our minister. He's going to pray for us. Amen. As he's preparing. And then we're going to put it in the hands of the pastor in that order. Mother's going to sing us a song. We're going to have prayer from the minister. And then we're going to put it in the hands of the pastor. Amen.
Oh, rising here, Father God. We thank you for meeting us here at this point in the name of Jesus, God. Thank you for each and every one that is here. Father God, bless us as we go. Bless us, God. Let us rise to our destinations real safely. This we ask and all the blessings in Jesus' name. And we turn it over to the hands of the pastor in Jesus' name.
To visit us here at New Beginnings Ministries of Orlando. We thank God for the Word of God. Amen. And the man of God that delivered the Word of God on this morning. Amen. Truly, he has preached out of his heart. Amen. And I believe he has done what the Lord has wanted him to do. Amen. Somebody just listen to the message. You're viewing us on Instagram. You're viewing us on Facebook. You may be on YouTube. And you may have come across this youth Sunday service. The youth have done a wonderful job this morning, haven't they? From the singing to the giving to the praying. Amen. The youth department comes second to none. Even in the midst of a pandemic. Amen. The children are yet coming to church. Amen. And we thank God for the parents. Even for the parents that send their children to church. Amen. There is no better place to be. And you listen to this message and you don't know Christ in the pardon of your sin. We don't want it to be said too late to enter into the golden gate. Remember, you have a place when this is all over, the hustle and bustle of life, when our jobs are over, when that last breath takes hold of your body. Amen. You want it to be said well with your soul. You may not know Christ. You may say, Brother Pastor, I don't know that if I was to die right now, I don't know where my soul would be. I want you to repeat after me, Father God, come to you in Jesus' name. I am a sinner. Clean me up. Forgive me. Father God, I denounce the devil. And I believe that you died and rose again on the third day with all power in your hands. Father God, I believe today by faith I am saved. Listen, if you just prayed that prayer, you are saved. And the angels in heaven are rejoicing over you. Amen. And if you, we now know you need what we call the gift of the Holy Ghost. So what I need you to do is send us a message through our app. Let us know who you are so that our staff can contact you and aid you into the gift of receiving the Holy Ghost. And you've been listening to us through our apps or through our messages. Amen. You want to become an e-member. Let us know. Amen. We'll be happy to have you in the family of New Beginnings Ministry of Orlando. We are a growing young church. Amen. And eyes have not seen and ears have not heard what God has in store for us and his people. Amen. We thank God. Aspiring missionary Sally has done a wonderful job today, hasn't she? Amen. We pray for the missing members that are not here for various reasons. We thank God for our administrator just popping up at the door. Praise the Lord. Amen. I'll give her an assignment to do. Amen. And she's looking at me crazy. Bless her heart. Aren't we glad to see her today? Amen. Amen. We're glad to see our friend, Brother Darius, Minister Darius, in the building. Amen. And his wonderful sons. Amen. I didn't know they were coming today, but we're so excited for him because the Lord has transitioned him into another area for his career. Amen. He has, listen y'all, listen. And it's good to be excited for other people.
Absolutely.
Because when you're excited for other people, when things happen to you, things also happen to you when you're excited for someone else. And the Lord has elevated him. Amen. He has earned his wings. Amen. And he is now the flight attendant. They make good money, y'all. Yeah, he's going to be flying the friendly skies, and he works for Frontier. Amen. Come on, let's put our hands together for him and congratulate him on his graduation. Amen. In his new area of where he's going to be working. Amen. We're grateful for him. Amen. And we send our love to his dear wife who's not here on this morning. She's sick. Okay. We pray for you, sis, right now, that the Lord heal your body wherever you are right now. Touch her from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet, God. Go into that room right now. Whatever it is, remove it right now, God, in the name of Jesus. And we give you glory. And we give you praise. Amen. We've done what we needed to do on this Youth Sunday. I'm excited what the women department now are getting ready to do. Amen. They're getting ready for their conference. Amen. The conference is underway, and I'm sure, amen, the men did a good job on ours. We did good. We're going to do better next year. Amen. We have some missing. We're going to do better next year. But I know the women are ready for their conference. If you have not registered, register. Register. Don't show up and not give anything or not pay anything. Amen. Amen. Register. Amen. So that the work of the Lord can go on. Amen. Let us stand. We're going to be dismissed. We're out in good time. It's 1:20. Deaconess Orlean has brought the time clock so that we can stay on schedule so she can go home and eat. Amen. We thank God for Lady Lawrence. She look wonderful and pretty on the floor. Amen. An excellent job she is doing for the work of the Lord. Father God, as we get ready to leave this place, but never from your presence, we pray, oh God, that you protect every member right now. Protect us all during the course of this week. Bind the hand of the enemy that tries to tear down. Bind the hand of the enemy, the death angel. I bind the death angel for it to be removed. In the name of Jesus, protect these members that are working for you, God. God, they need healthy bodies to work for you, God. God, they need income to work for you. So, God, now I pray that you prosper this membership in the name of Jesus. God, if you prosper us, we can do what you would have us to do for kingdom building. And so we give you glory. In Jesus' name, thank God. Amen. We are dismissed.